महाकाय सूर्य कोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वते नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदं। वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ। येनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
अयुन्
ऋलक्
एओं
एओं
अयौच
अयौच
हयवरट
हयवरट
लन्
लन्
न्यमङ्गणनम्
न्यमङ्गणनम्
जनै
जनै
घटदश
घटदश
जबगडदश
जबगडदश
खप चठथ चटतौ
खप चठथ
कपै
कपै
शशसर
शशसर
हल
हल
कैन रिपीट आफ्टर मी। अकारान्तः पुल्लिङ्गः रामशब्दः
अकारान्तः पुल्लिङ्गः रामशब्दः
You do the homework. Just trying different shabdas. Akaranta, ikaranta.
Yes, yes, Guruji.
Yes, Guruji.
Okay. Take at least 4 or 5 words from that list of words what I gave, what I showed in the last class, or in the first the book. Try to practice that. Ikaranta, akaranta, ikaranta, ukaranta. To start with. रामः रामौ रामाः
रामः रामौ रामाः
रामं रामौ रामान्
रामं रामौ रामान्
रामेण रामाभ्यां रामैः
रामेण रामाभ्यां
रामाय रामाभ्यां रामेभ्यः
रामाय रामाभ्यां
रामेभ्यः रामात् रामाभ्यां रामेभ्यः Some audio problem is there, I think. Can you all hear me?
Yes, Guruji. Yes, Guruji.
Ikarantaha pullingaha hari shabdaha.
Ikarantaha pullingaha hari
shabdaha.
Harihi hari harayaha.
Harihi
hari harayaha.
Harim hari harina.
Harim
hari
harina.
Harina haribhyam. Haribihi
Harina
Haribhyam Haribihi
Haraye Haribhyam Haribhyaha
Haraye Haribhyam Haribhyaha
Haraye Haribhyam Haribhyaha
Haraye Haribhyam Haribhyaha
Haraye Haryoho Harinam
Harihe Haryoh Harinam
Harau Haryoh Harishu
Harau
Harihe
Haryoh
Harishu
He Hare He Hari He Harayaha
He Hare
He Hari
Harayaha
Harayaha Hariyaha So, if we know this Shabda Hari, in Ikaranta Pullinga Shabda is declinable. But what each word? Vibhakti Vachanam, Pratama Vibhakti Ekavachanam Harihi. Pratama Vibhakti Bhivachanam Hari. Pratama Vibhakti Bhagavachanam Harayaha. What happens to the word Hari? If you watch and just know what replaces the letter E, which is Hari. E is the Anta, Ika, E is the Anta of the Pratipadika Hari. So Ikara Anta, but E, the last letter of the Pratipadika Hari, the E, is replaced for each Vibhakti Vachanam by some. Pratama Vibhakti Hari, on Visarga is added, Harihi. If it is Kavi, Kavihi, Kapi, Kapihi, Rishi, Rishihi, Muni, Munihi. Same may you extend to other forms. In Dvivachanam, it is Hari is there. In Dvivachanam, Hari is there. So, Hari, that E, has become long E. The short E has become long E. Hari. So, Muni will become Muni. Rishi will become Rishi. Similarly, Bhagavachanam Harayaha is there. The word Hari has become Harayaha. So what would have happened? That E is replaced by Ayaha. Harayaha into individual words. Hakara plus Akara plus Repa plus Akara plus Repa plus Akara plus Yakara plus Akara. You can see. Ayaha is the last word. Last letter, not word. Last A and Yaha. So that replaces the E, the last letter of the Pratipadikam. So Har plus E, Hari. Har plus Ayaha. Harayaha. So E is replaced by Ayaha. The same thing you extend to other Shabda. Rishi will become Rish plus E, Rishi. Rish plus Ayaha, Rishayaha. So he is replaced by Ayaha. This is not new, already I taught. I'm just helping you to see that. So if you know this, the same way, you can define the Shabdas. It comes only by practice. And here you need to note, Dvitya Vibhakti Bahuvachanam, it is Harim. Here, Hari is short E, Pratipadikam. Here, Harin, E becomes long, Harin. At two places, it becomes. And other, all other places, the Hari, the E is short. In these two places, that is Dvitya Vibhakti Bahuvachanam and Shashti Vibhakti Bhagavacham, Harinam. So these two places, the Rasva E becomes Dirga E, Harin, Harinam. In all other places, it is short. Of course, in Dvivachanam, Pratama Vibhakti Dvivachanam, Ditya Vibhakti Dvivachanam, Hari, that long is there. That is there. That will be there. Hari, Hari. Oh, if you take that also, there will be five places. Pratama Vibhakti Dvivachanam, Ditya Vibhakti Dvivachanam, and Ditya Vibhakti Bhagavachanam, Hari, and Shashti Vibhakti Bhagavachanam, Harina, and Sambodhana, Ditya Vibhakti Hari. So in these five places, if you want, you can take these five places, becomes long E. Similarly, Guru also. So in Dvivachanam, in Dvivachanams, Pratama Vibhakti, Dvitya Vibhakti, and Sambodhana Pratama. These are the places where E you will see. And in Bhagavachanam, Dvitya Vibhakti and Shashti Vibhakti. Hari, Hari. This you can note. So that you don't mistakes, you don't say Harin. It is Harin. Not Harina. Harinam. Okay. The same way for Guru Shabda. You can repeat. Ukarantaha Pullingaha Guru Shabdaha.
Ukarantaha Pullingaha Guru Shabdaha.
Guru Guru Guravaha.
Guru,
Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru
Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru
Guru Guru
Guru
Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru Guru
Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru,
Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Guru, Who is Dirga? Actually, Bhagavachanam, Guru Na Dirga. So, two places Dirga in Bhagavachanam. And in Vivachanam, Pratama, Dvitiya, and Sambodhana, in three places you see that who becomes who. So, this you can note. Okay. Then we'll move on. So, these three Shabda you need to memorize. Have you memorized these three Shabda? If you have memorized, then I can introduce another Shabda also.
Yes, Guruji.
Okay. You can keep adding more Shabda. So I keep another Shabda also. First, pulling the Shabda. Okay. Another simple Shabda. Okay. Before this. A, E, U, we have seen. Akaranta is Rama Shabda. Ikaranta is Hari Shabda. And Ukaranta is Guru Shabda. Now, Napumsakalinga, we will see. Simple. Apum Sankalinga is the simplest Shabda. The Pala Shabda is simplest Shabda. Before the Tatiya Bhakti onwards, Pratyayam words is same as Pullinga. So, what you need to know is Prathama and Dvitiya Vibhakti alone. And that too, Prathama and Dvitiya, the forms are same. So, therefore, there is nothing specially. Both are done, Prathama and Dvitiya. Only three words you need to know. Palam, Pale, Palani. That's all. If you know this, the Shabda is known to you. Understand? Akarantaha, Napum Sakalingaha, Palashabdaha.
Akarantaha, Napum Sakalingaha,
Palam Shabdaha.
Palam, Pale, Palani.
Palam, Pale, Palani.
Palam, Pale, Palani.
Palam, Pale, Palani.
Palena, Palhabhyam, Palaihi.
Palena,
Palabhyam, Palaihi. You can watch here. Ramena, Ramabhyam, Ramaihi. The same way, Palena, Palabhyam, Palaihi. Rama Shabda, you know, then from here onwards, you know. Palaya, Palabhyam, Palaibhyaha.
Palaya,
Palani. You need to know. That's it. Otherwise, same. Palam, Pale, Palani only. If you know this, Pala Shabda is known. If you know Rama Shabda, this is Shabda is known to you. Very simple Shabda, Pala Shabda. Let me introduce another Shabda also. We will see the pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, Tat Shabda. This Shabda also, if you know Rama Shabda, almost similar to Rama Shabda, not exactly, similar. I will show you the similarity. Then you can easily understand. You can remember. Understand this. Dakarantaha Pullingaha Tad Shabdaha.
Dakarantaha Pullingaha Tad Shabdaha.
What does it mean, Tad?
Far.
That means far away.
That. Yeah. That he or she.
That which is far away. Yes. Then Prathama Vibhakti. Sahataute.
Sahataute.
Tam tautan.
Tam tautan.
You can watch here. Tam tautan. Take the Rama Shabda. What is a Dvitiya Vibhakti for Rama Shabda?
Ramam, Rama, Ramana.
Same thing here. Tam, Tau, Tan. What is the difference? Is it same or not?
Same.
Only thing is, here, Pratamarinati, Ekavachana, Sa, you will see. In all other places, you will see only Ta, only you say Tau, Te, Tam, Ta. Everywhere, Ta is the Tachabda. Tachabda. Ta is the letter Ta. That is what you see everywhere. Only in Pratama Vibhakti you see Sa. And everywhere it is Sa. So Dvitiya Vibhakti becomes Tam. Dvitiya Vibhakti Dvivachana becomes Tau, like Ramu. So Tam, Tau, Tan. Suppose Ta is a Shabda. If Ta is a Shabda, what will be the form? Akaranta, Pullingaha, Ta, Shabdaha. Dvitiya Vibhakti will be Tam, Tau, Tan. That is what the form is. Taha taute, tam tautan. There is no taha. Instead of taha, Prathama Vibhakti Ekavachanam, the form is saha. Only that you need to remember. In your mind, you can think, you can imagine that Pratipadikam is takara. Iti, you can imagine. If you imagine, then it is like Rama Shabda. So, saha, only that is only the exception. Afterwards, taute, of course, te is different. Okay, Raghuvachan te is different. That you note, Tam Tautan, same as Rama Shabda. Then Tritiya Vibhakti Rama Shabda is? चतुर्थी विभक्ति अगेन चतुर्थी विभक्ति एकवचनम इज डिफरेंट तस्मै दैट यू नीड टू नोट तस्मै दैट इज डिफरेंट वेयरस ताभ्यां तेभ्यः लाइक रामाय द्विवचनं बहुवचनं सेम एज राम शब्द तस्मै ताभ्यां तेभ्यः
तस्मै
Now, panchami. Again, in ekavachanam, you will see some difference. Drama shabda. Otherwise, it is same. Without, there will be some difference. Without difference, then all shabda cannot be single, right? There should be some difference between the shabdas. Panchami is tasmat. Pratama vibhakti ekava, that is, panchami vibhakti ekavachanam is tasmat. That you can note. And dvivachanam bhagavachanam, same. As Rama, Rama Bhyam Ramebhyaha, Ramat Rama Bhyam Ramebhyaha, Yat Tasmad Tabhyam Tebhyaha.
Tebhyaha.
So base is Rama Shabda, very important. If you know it, many Shabdas you know. Tasmad Tabhyam Tebhyaha.
Tasmad Tabhyam Tebhyaha.
Tebhyaha. Tasya Tayoho Tesham. What is the Rama Shabda?
Ramasya
Ramana.
Ramasya here becomes Tasya. Ramayogo becomes Tayogo. You can see the similarity. Bhagavachanam is different. Ramana, here it is Tesham. That you need to know. Note. Wherever difference is there, that you can know. Okay. Then. सप्तमी तस्मिन् तयोः तेषु
तस्मिन् तस्मिन् तयोः तेषु
नाम शब्द इस
रामे
रामेषु
रामे या इंस्टेड ऑफ रामे तस्मिन् चेंज इज देयर द चेंज यू नीड टू नोट तस्मिन् वेयरस द्विवचनं बहुवचनं सेम तयोः रामयोः रामेषु तेषु राइट This shabda is simple. It's one of the simple shabda. So you can note. Saha you need to note. In fact, if you know ekavachanam, that is enough. Ekavachanam, you note. You can saha, tam, tena, tasmai, tasma, tasya, tasmin. Ekavachanam, you know. Other forms are same as Rama shabda, except shashti vibhakti bhagavachanam, which is tesham. Only these six, seven plus one, eight words you know. You know. Yeah, all the words. If you know this shabda, then the next shabda, some other shabda, demonstrative pronouns and interrogative pronouns, which we are going to see, that can be known easily. So this is the base for that. So you can see the connection, how the connection is made to the shabdas. So Rama shabda is the base for this, and this will be the base for the shabdas we are going to come later. So you need to memorize this also. Okay. You can do this. Now we will continue with the lessons. I'll call the names, then they can read. Lesson number 38, I think. And before we read, from this Friday 7 o'clock, 7:15, Gita class is there. Only shloka, the meaning, and simple commentary. I told you this. I'm already doing a Shankara Bhashyam. Now 100 classes are over. But we'll go for a long time. It is in depth with the Shankara Bhashyam. A lot of Sanskritam will be there. But this Gita class will be Shloka, simple meaning of the Shloka and simple commentary. Based on Shankara Bhashyam, not Shankara Bhashyam. So this, I'm not forming any WhatsApp group. The link for the class, I will send it to all the groups. So whoever interested can join. I think I already announced, right? To this group.
Yes, no, Guruji.
Yes.
No, I don't think.
No.
No, you haven't.
I will send the link.
Not in the Sanskritam class.
Okay. Yeah. I will send this link for the class to all the groups. So this is a Friday, 7 o'clock. So if you see the link, you understand it is Gita class. I'm not forming a separate group and adding people.
Over Guruji, 7 p.m. or 7 a.m.?
For me, 7 a.m. India.
Okay.
Someone means because after 7 o'clock, another Sanskritam class is there for me after that class. Someone means maybe 7:10, it could be.
Yeah, okay. I'm just inquiring because 7 p.m. would be for me a little beyond the time, that's why.
Yes. So.
Thank you.
And whoever interested, you can pass the information, you can join. Okay. So now, Priyaji, you can read.
Thank you, Guruji.
Yes, Ji. Ete Harinaha. स्तः एते पुस्तके स्तः एते पुस्तक स्तः एते पुस्तके संति
एते पुस्तके संति
स्तः
नाउ लेट मी आस्क वन क्वेश्चन एनीबडी कैन आंसर एते हरिणः एते इज What gender is it?
It's pullinga. Pullinga. Because Harina. Harina is pullinga. That's why
plural.
Harinaha is a Harina. Yes. Harina is the pullinga. Therefore, ete must be the pronoun must be pullinga. That is number one. And the gender. Sorry, first is gender. Second one, vachanam. Harinaha bahu vachanam. Therefore, the pronoun also must be bahu vachanam. Okay. Ete Harinaha. Therefore, staha will come.
Santi.
Santi.
Santi. Okay, number one. Santi. Kriyaji, you said staha.
Yes, Sri. Okay. Yes, Sri.
Ete Harinaha Santi. Okay, anyway, if we are not yet started the exercise, it's okay. Ete Harinaha Santi. So, Harina is the proper noun. And Ete is the pronoun. So the gender of the pronoun can be known from the proper noun. You need to remember this. The gender of the proper, the pronoun is determined by the gender of the pronoun determined the proper noun. So Harina is the Akaranta Pullinga Shabda. Therefore, you have to use the corresponding linga and vachanam. Vibhakti also. Vibhakti, Prathama Vibhakti, Bhagu Vachanam and Pullinga. Ete. So correspondingly, you have to use. So, ete arinaha. Because Bhagavachanam, therefore Kriyapadam is Bhagavachanam, Santi. Right? Ete arinaha Santi. Now, the second one, ete pustake. Here, pustake is what?
Napunsakalingam.
What Vibhakti?
Dvitiya.
Why Dvitiya?
Pradhama Vibhakti.
We have not yet seen Dvitiya at all. We have not seen the
usage
of
Pustake only. Prathama Vibhakti only.
Dvivachanam. Dvivachanam. Sorry, not Dvitiya. Dvivachanam.
It is Dvivachanam.
So, I had one question regarding previous. How is Harina?
Let me complete this and then we can ask. Pustake is Dvivachanam. Prathama Vibhakti Dvivachanam. Two books. And the pronoun Etat is used. Therefore, it must conform to the Vibhakti Vachanam. Etat, Ete.
Ete.
Right? Ete. That is also Prathama Vibhakti, Vivachanam. And the gender is Ete. It is Napumsakalinga. Ete Pustake. Now, the Kriyapadam should conform with the number.
Staha.
Kriyapadam should conform with the Purusha and the number.
Vachan.
Purusha is that? Doesn't mean gender here. Okay. Purusha means person. First person, second person, third person. That is called Purusha.
Pradama Purusha.
Nothing to do with the gender here.
Purusha.
Who is the person? Ete Pustake. Is it first person, second person, or third person in English? We say first person. It is. Third person, not first person, right? Third person. Third person is called Prathama Purusha in Sanskritam. So you need to know all those things. Purusha, Vachanam, Linga. Understand the difference between this. So Purusha doesn't mean Linga. I'm not asking the Linga.
Gender.
Purusha is person. whether it's first person, second person, or third person. And third person in English is Prathama Purusha in Sanskritam. You need to know that. And second person is Madhyama Purusha. And first person is Uttama Purusha. Therefore, here Ete Pustake is Prathama Purusha. It is third person. So, the Kriyapadam depends on the person. Number one, that is called Purusha. I said Purusha, Prathama Purusha. Number two, on the Vachanam. On the Vachanam. What Vachanam? Dvivachanam. Therefore, Kriyapadam should match with the Dvivachanam. So, Asti, Staha, Santi, three things are there. All the three are what Purusha?
Prathama Purusha.
There is no doubt, Prathama Purusha. Asti, Staha. If Prathama Purusha is there, what is Prathama Purusha? Prathama Purusha is neither you nor me. That's called Prathama Purusha. Simple way to understand. Yep. If it is I or we two or we all, it is Uttama Purusha, first person.
Yep.
If it is you, you two, you all, it is Madhyama Purusha, second person. It is somebody, he and he two and he all or he or she or whatever it may be.
Okay.
Other, instead of saying that, I'd say other than you and me, everything is Prathama Purusha, right? Other than you and me, everything else, whatever can be denoted by other than the word I and you, they are all Prathama Purusha. So, Yete is these. These means Prathama Purusha. Okay. So, Asti, Staha, Santi, these are the Kriyapadam for the Prathama Purusha. Asti, Prathama Purusha, Ekavachanam, Staha, Prathama Purusha, Dvivachanam, Santi, Prathama Purusha, Bahuvachanam. So now, depending on the Purusha and the Vachanam, you have to select the right one from this three. Asti, Saha, Santi. Ete, Arinaha is there. It is Prathama Purusha. Only Prathama Purusha we are seeing. And the choice are there. Asti, Saha, Santi. Which one you will select? Based on the Vachanam, Santi.
Guruji, voice is breaking, Guruji. It's only very breaking. Small. No, not a big deal.
Okay. See, I am. Net is fine. I don't know why it is breaking. It will be all right.
Yeah, there's at times a little lag. That's all, Guruji. That's fine.
Okay. Ete pustake. Here, pustake is dvivachanam. Ete pustake dvivachanam. And you have three asti staha santi. Three options are there. So which one you will select? Select the dvivachanam.
Staha.
You do like this, you will not do mistake. Now, we have got this, this is now only Prathama Purusha we are dealing, therefore, Asti, Staha, Santi. Later when we see Madhyama Purusha, Uttama Purusha, accordingly the Kriyapadam will come. So, you will have more choices than you have to select. That also you can be filtered out. I'm just helping you to easy way to understand this. Okay. Purusha must match and Vachanam must match. What about Linga? Linga should match or not? Anybody?
Yes, it should.
Yes.
With the Kriyapadam?
No, there is no linga for Kriyapadam.
No linga.
Yeah, Kriya doesn't have linga. Whether I eat or you eat or somebody eats. Eat is eat only. The man eats it, man eats. The woman also eat only, right? So, there is no change in the Kriyapadam. So, it nothing to do with the linga.
Yes.
Okay. All these confusions can happen. That's why clarifying it. For Kriyapadam, there is no linga. When it comes to Kriyapadam, what you have to see is the Purusha and the Vachanam, person and the number. Okay, now, what is your question? Somebody has asked.
My question is, Ete is plural, so how is Harinaha plural?
Harinaha, Harino, Harinaha, Ramashabdavatu.
So, the original word is Harina?
Yes.
Or Harinaha?
How can be Harinaha?
Okay, like Ramaha, Ramaha, Ramau, Ramaha.
Harinaha, Harinau, Harinaha.
Exactly. So it's Harinaha. The original word is Harinaha.
You cannot say original word is Harinaha.
Harinaha.
Ramaha, for that original is Rama. Harinaha, for that original is?
Harinaha.
You cannot say Harinaha. If you add Visarga, then it becomes a Padam, not a Pratipadika. Okay. Now,
thank you. Ete pustake staha, te balike staha, एते बालकाः बालकाः सन्ति एते
ते
सॉरी ते ते कलिके तः
ते
पर्णे
नेक्स्ट पर्सन इंदिरा जी कैन रीड
ते पर्णे ते पर्णे स्तः
यस
ते बालकाः सन्ति एते ग्रन्थाः सन्ति ते माले स्तः ते आसन्दाः सन्ति
ओके नेक्स्ट पर्सन गिरिजा
यस गुरुजी ते ते लेखन्यौ सन्ति लेखन्यः नो लेखन्यः is ikaranta okay this is te lekhanyo staha
when you say te, au
yes guruji
remember
yep nadi yes. nadyo yep te phale staha yete
samo lekhanyo
sorry guruji I missed yours
wherever see when you see the word ending with au Remember, it could be Dvivachan.
Dvivachan, yeah.
Ramau, Harau, Harau is different. Hari is there. And,
even in Nadi, Nadiyo it
Nadiyo.
Becomes.
That's what it is. Dekani yeah. is Nadi Shabdavat. Okay.
Yeah.
So, Rama and Nadi, how is that Dvivachan?
Dvivachan, yeah.
And Hari is different, okay. There is no Hari, Harau. Harau is Saptamival.
That is pulling
Hari, right. Hari becomes.
That's okay. Gender doesn't matter. Just I'm saying, wherever it is, how is that? It is
generally Dvivachan. Yeah.
So Rama becomes when the Ramo is that Lekani Lekanyo. Hari don't say Harav. If you say Harav, it is Saptami Bhakti.
Yeah.
Okay, that is different. Similarly, Guru becomes Gurav. That is Saptami Bhakti.
Hmm.
So in Prathama Vibhakti, I'm saying in Prathama Vibhakti, when you see how it is Dvivachan.
Yep.
Yeah. Then.
ते फले स्तः एते द्विचक्रिके स्तः एते चक्रे स्तः एते पुरुषाः सन्ति
नेक्स्ट पर्सन श्रुति जी ओके आई थिंक नो रिस्पांस फ्रॉम द माइक इज नॉट नेक्स्ट पर्सन अनंत कुमार जी कैन
Yes, Guruji.
Number 16.
Number 16. Te Mayuraha Santi.
Voice is feeble.
Is it okay, Guruji?
Yes, now it's okay.
Te Mayuraha Santi. Te Mayur Yohu.
Mayur Yohu.
Mayur Yohu. Te Mayur Yohu. Te Mayur Yohu. Okay.
That's not what I said. Oh.
Mayurha Mayuryau. Ha, correct. Te Mayuryau Santi?
How can be Santi? If Prathama Vibhakti ends with Au, I said it is Dvivachanam.
Yes, Guruji. Staha. Te Mayuryau Staha.
Yes.
Ete Amre Ete Amre Ete
Amra is like What is Amra?
Amra
Akaranta.
Akanata.
Linga.
It is Amra.
Napumsakalinga.
Napumsakalinga. Napumsakalinga.
Amre is that. So connect with Palashabda.
Yes, Palam Pale.
Yeah, Palam Pale. Therefore?
Ete Amre Staha.
Yes, that's all you have to connect them.
Yes, Guruji.
That is you need to do. Are you all doing homework? Just going to the lessons?
Yes, Guruji. Yes, Guruji. We are doing
yes,
it.
Yes, Guruji.
The coordination and it is a little bit more.
That takes time. That's why Pabhyasa. That's why practice.
Yes, Guruji.
Homework. Yeah.
Te late staha.
Yes.
Te vijane santi.
Why santi?
Te vijane.
Te vijana means fan.
Yeah, correct. Te vijane staha.
Te is sir. Tat te tani. Napumsakalinga. Vijana. Vijanam vijane vijanani. You can see. Te vijane staha.
Yes.
Take this alone. Te vijane staha. And just tell you on all the ling, all the vachanam.
Yes, Guruji.
Tat vyajanam asti. Tat vyajanam asti. Te vyajane staha. Tani vyajanani santi. If you can do like this for all the sentences, very good exercise.
Yes, Guruji. No clear, yes.
Okay, next person.
Guruji, are you able to hear me?
Yes, now I can hear. You can read now. Yes.
Okay,
Kriya Parichayaha. Now, from this lesson onwards, Kriya Padam is introduced. Kriya Padam is a very big topic. I will introduce again in another way. Another way means in a detailed way. Prepare some notes for this. But now let us go with the flow of this book. Okay. You can read now.
Okay.
Kriya Padam means what?
Verb.
Verb. Padam.
Padam.
Padam means word. Shabda means pratipadikam. Okay. Dhatu is verb. Kriya Padam is verbal form.
Verbal form.
Just to make you remember quickly. Shabda is converted into padam. Shabda, that is otherwise called pratipadikam, is converted to padam by adding some suffixes. The structure called, remember the word for suffix?
Pratyaya.
Pratyaya. So, shabda, otherwise called pratipadikam, which is a crude noun base. Noun base, what is crude? It is noun base. The noun base is converted into noun form by adding some suffixes. Noun form, that is called namapadam.
Namapadam.
And dhatu, that is verbs, verbal roots, are converted into verbal form by adding some suffixes, and the verbal forms are called
Kriyapadam.
These Namapadam and Kriyapadam only can be used in the language. You cannot use a Shabda. You cannot use a Dhatu as such. Okay. Dhatu should be converted to a Kriyapadam. Shabda should be converted to Namapadam. And the Padam is a technical word. So this Namapadam and Kriyapadam only can be used in the language. Right? Fine. Now, some Kriyapadams are given. When you say Kriyapadam, what are the things should come to your mind? Kriyapadam, when a verb is there, means number one, Purusha.
Purusha vachanam.
Vachanam.
What Purusha? What Vachanam? Right? These two
no
things
need.
Are.
Only action.
Action. Action means Purusha. Pratama Purusha, Madhyama Purusha, Uttama Purusha. And what vachanam? Ek vachanam, dvi vachanam, bahu vachanam. There is no linga here. Okay. So now you will be exposed to the some kriyapadams which are in Pratama Purusha. And Pratama Purusha kriyapadam, Pratama Purusha ek vachana kriyapadam, you can identify by the last letter. That is a suffix.
T.
It gives you a lot of information. We are going to see later. It gives a lot of information about that Kriyapadam. The T, the suffix. T is a suffix. Okay. It gives a lot of information about Kriyapadam. So T is there. It means Pratama Purusha, that is first person.
Ekavachana.
Pratama Purusha is the third person, not first person. Pratama Purusha, that is third person, and Ekavachana. So you can remember this. T is third person singular. Pratama Purusha Ekavachanam. Okay. So you need to know the Kriyapadam and their meanings. Now you can read Shrutiji.
Patati, Likhati.
You can tell the meaning in English.
Okay. Patati means reading. Likhati.
Reads.
Reads, sorry.
Who reads?
Balaha.
Balaha Patati.
Balaha Patati.
Can you say Balau Patati?
Balau Patanti.
Patataha. We are going to see whether it is Taha or Patanti and all. Okay. Balau Patataha, is it correct? No, it is not correct.
No.
Because T is there, it is Ekavachanam. Balav is Dvivachanam. Therefore, Balau Patati is not correct. Only that much is enough. Whether it is Patataha or Patanti, we will see later. Okay. Patati is there, Balaha Patati only. It cannot be Balau Patati. It cannot be Balaha Patati also. Wrong. Because, why it is wrong?
That's plural.
This is only for ekavachanam patati.
Vachanam doesn't match. Therefore, the sentence is not correct. For the sentence with the kriyapadam to be correct, it should match with the vachanam and the purusha. Balaha is prathama purusha. Fine. But patati is ekavachanam. Therefore, balaha patati only. It cannot be balav patati. Balav is prathama purusha, but vachanam is vivachanam. Patati is ekavachanam. Mismatch of vachanam. The sentence is not correct. Understand?
Yes,
Guruji.
Balaha likati.
Balaha likati writes. Means the boy writes.
Boy yes. writes. Mm. Balaha kridati. Boy plays. Balaha namati. The boy prays. Praying. Like praying.
The boy prays. The boy is praying. Both are okay. In Sanskritam, we don't have the present continuous tense.
Okay.
Boy prays or boy is praying? Balaha namati only.
Balaha gayati, boys, the boy sings. Balaha hasati, the boy laughs. Balaha kadati, the boy eats. Balaha patati, the boy falls.
False.
Balaha gachati, the boy comes.
Goes.
Sorry. The balaha agachati, the boy goes.
Comes.
Oh, gachati and agachati.
Both gachati are... goes, agachati comes.
Comes. Yeah. Balaha pashyati. The boy looks or sees.
Okay.
Yeah. Balaha vadati. The boy talks. Balaha upavishati. The boy resting.
Sits.
Upavishati sits. The balaha uttishtati. The boy
Or uttishtati also can mean stand up also. He stands up.
Stand up. Okay.
Yeah.
The boy dhavati.
Runs.
Balaha dhavati.
Okay.
The boy runs.
Yeah, understood. No problem. So these are the kriyapadam. Okay. So you can be familiar with this. Patati, likati, kridati, namati, gayati, hasati, kadati, patati, gachati, agachati, pashyati, vadati, upavishati, uttishtati, davati. You can write sentences. Saha or sa. Suppose it is sa. Sa. Saha upavishati. Sa.
Sa upavishati.
Upavishati. Because sa is Srilinga, therefore another kriyapada. No. Kriyapadam doesn't have to do anything with the gender. What maybe the gender, Kriyapadam is going to be same. So that you make it very clear.
Guruji, what is Vadati?
Speaks.
Speaks.
Now the next person, Kausalyaji, can read. Now you can add the Sa. Previously, Balaha, now you can say Sa or Balika, you can say.
Balika Patati, Balika Likhati, Balika Kridati, Balika namati, balika gayati, balika hasati, balika khadati, balika patati, balika gachati, balika agachati, balika pashyati, balika vadati, balika upavishati, balika uttishtati, balika dhavati.
You know why two times he is giving? One is male, other one is female, to understand the kriyapadam.
There is no change
in Kriyapadam with respect to gender. That is why he's giving. That's what I've been saying from the beginning. So he's showing it. Okay. So now the next one. Next person. Jyotiji. Now you need to know the Kriyapadam. Then only you can fill in the blank.
Balakaha uttishtati.
Yes.
Balakaha namati.
Yes.
Balakaha prakshalayati washes.
Please note this. Prakshalayati washes. Yes.
Balakaha bhramati, he roams around.
Yeah.
Balakaha snati, takes a bath.
Snati, snanam, takes a bath. Okay.
Balakaha archati, he does prayer, he prays.
He worships. He does puja. Okay. Yeah, he worships. Okay.
Balakaha khadati, he eats. Balakaha pibati, he drinks. Balakah gacchati, he goes.
Yes, 1 minute. Yeah, what's the question?
Guruji, what is the difference between namati for praying and the other word for praying?
Namati is praise, archati is worships.
Okay.
Yeah, continue.
Balakah gacchati, he goes. Balakah arohati, he climbs.
Yeah, arohati, climbs. Avarohati, climbs down. Next person. Krishna Kumar, you can leave this.
Balaha upavishati, the boy sits. Balaha avatarati, the boy gets down. Balaha pravishati, the boy enters. Balaha patati, the boy reads. Balaha likati, the boy writes. Balaha
16.
Kridayati. Kridayati, the boy plays.
No.
Kridati.
Kridati.
The balaha kridati, not kridayati.
Okay.
If it is kridayati, means the boy is, the boy causes to play. Okay. Doesn't cause anyone to play. He plays. He's not the coach to make the members play. Right?
Balaha kridati, boy plays.
Difference between the coach and the player. Players play. Coach cause the players to play. If it is a coach, then kridayati.
Okay.
If the players are there, kridati. Like patati. Patati is reads.
So like active and passive voice.
Not active and passive. Passive. No, it is causative. Causing to do.
Okay.
Causative. Patati reads. Patayati. Causing to read. What is causing to read? Teaching. Balaha patati. Boy reads. Acharyaha patayati. Acharya cause to read. It means teaches. So patati, patayati. Khadati, eats. Khadayati, cause to eat. What is cause to eat?
Okay.
Feeding. Feeding.
Feeding. Okay.
Feeding. Serving.
Yeah.
Khadati eats. Balaha khadati. Mata khadayati. Mata khadayati means
feeds.
So that is causative form. We will see that later. Because you said kridayati. That is why I'm saying some examples. Okay. Kridati only.
Okay.
Continue.
Balaha agachati.
Yes.
Balaha pashyati. Balaha vadati. The boy speaks. Balaha nidrati. The boy sleeps.
Sleeps. Nidrati. Sleeps. Then the next person. Manjulaji.
Guruji.
You can read.
Balaha patati. Balika kridati.
You can say davati also. Your choice. It's okay. Kridati, davati.
Guruji.
Here.
Taruna davati. Tarunaha yes. Davati. Bhaktaha namati or
archati.
Archati.
Anyone, it's your choice. Whatever you want to say. Tarunaha means what? Youth.
Boy.
Young boy.
Young boy.
Continue.
Yeah. Vilam Taruni.
Yes. Balas Kavat. Yes.
Gayakaha. Gayati. Singer is sings.
Yes.
Singer sings. Nataha. Natati.
Natati.
Nrityati.
Yeah.
Nrityati, we have not seen, it's going to come. Nataha. Nrityati. Dances. Nrityati.
Okay, Guruji.
Okay.
Nataha nrityati. Vanaraha.
Sits on the branch.
Upavishati.
Upavishati.
Okay.
Balakaha khadati.
Khadati.
Okay.
Putri khadati. Guruji, we can say Mata khadanti also.
No, don't say. You say putri.
Adayati.
Mata is not there.
Mata kadayati.
Mata, the word is not there. Therefore, putri kadati. That's all.
Okay, Guruji. Putri kadati. Vruddha
pashyati.
Pashyati. Vruddha pashyati.
Let us say. Others can watch. Yeah.
Adhyapakaha. Teaching.
Adhyapakaha teaches or he sees? Because the word teaches we have not seen yet.
Okay. Pashyati.
Part, you can say patayati. Can add patayati.
Patayati.
Yes.
Vruddha.
Upavishyati.
Upavishyati.
Janani.
Janani.
Cooks.
Cooks.
Patati.
Pachati.
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 Janani pachati. Okay. Choraha.
Chorayati. We are going to see. Okay, this Kriya Padam we don't know. It's going to come. Okay. Choraha. Chorayati.
Chorayati. Yatrika pidati. Yatrikaha.
Yatrikaha. Pidati. Yes, one minute. Somebody is asking doubt. Yes.
Chorayati, you told him. Causal.
No, it's not causative. Chorayati is he steals only.
Okay.
Okay. Yatrikaha pibati dhanikaha givindara
dadati
yachati.
Yachati.
The kriya padams are given, I think, here below. You can maybe it's given, not given here, but okay, anyway. You can note the kriya padam, whatever I said. Dhanikaha yachati. Yachati is a kriya padam, gives. Choraha chorayati steals. Janani pachati. So the kriyapadams, whatever I said, you can note. So many kriyapadams you have seen, more than 15. Now he is giving kriyapadam and the equivalent of it. Karoti is another important kriyapadam. Please note this. We will see in detail later. Karoti means does. Karoti means does. Saha karoti, he does. The example you can see, Balaha Namati is the Balaha boy salutes. Now, which is equal to saying, Balakaha Namanam Karoti. He does Namaskara. Bala does Namaskara, the boy salutes. Both are same. The boy salutes, the boy does Namaskara. So, when you say Karoti, does what? Namanam. Namanam is derived from the verb. From the verb it is derived. Namanam means namaskara. Namanam karoti.
Is that this?
Sorry? Yeah, please tell me. Girijari.
Is it dvitiya vibhakti? Ra. Yes. Namanam.
Dvitiya vibhakti.
Okay, thank you.
He does namaskara. The object of doing is namaskara. Namanam karoti. So, just be familiar with the forms. That is enough now. Namati is equal to Namanam Karoti. Smaranam is equal to Smaranam Karoti. Brahmanam is equal to Brahmanam Karoti. So, some forms are given using Karoti. Now, the next person can read. Who is the next person?
Guruji, one doubt, Guruji.
Yeah.
What is the Dhatu Pad? Dhatu, we don't need, Guruji. Is it?
What is the? I didn't get you. What is it?
For these Kriya Padams and this Namati, all these things.
Uh-huh.
What is the base
Kriya Dhatu. Base? You're asking what is the other, the Dhatus?
Yes, Guruji.
Dhatus we will see later. Don't worry. Just know the Kriya Padam and its meaning.
Okay, Guruji.
Next person can read. Neeraj.
Balakaha Namati, Balakaha Namanam Karoti.
So you need to understand Namati is equal to Namanam Karoti. Be familiar with the words Namanam, Smaranam, Brahmanam. Okay.
Balakaha Smarati, Balakaha Smaranam Karoti, Balakaha Brahmati, Balakaha Brahmanam Karoti, Balakaha Roditi, Balakaha Rodanam Karoti, Balakaha Dhyayati, Balakaha Dhyayan Karoti.
Dhyanam Karoti. Okay. Dhyayati is Dhyanam Karoti.
karoti. Dhyanam karoti.
I hope you all understand the meaning of these kriya padams.
Yes, Guruji.
Namati is salutes, smarati is remembers.
Brahmati.
Note the meaning if you don't know. Balaka smarati remembers. Brahmati walks around. Roditi cries. Balaka cries.
Guruji, what is roditi?
Cry. Cries. Okay. Boy cries. Balaka dhyayati. It does meditates.
Guruji, one doubt, Guruji. Brahmati is wanders. Can we take
this? That's for moving around, wandering around. Yes.
Then for walking, is there any other word? Normal walk.
Chalati.
Chalati, you can say.
Okay.
Chalati.
Or gachati, agachati.
Yes.
Going.
Chalati. Chalati is walks. Moves.
Okay.
Continue.
Balakah nindati Guruji.
Sorry.
What's the meaning of nindati?
Nindati.
I'll say let her read first. Yeah.
Okay. Balakah nindati. Balakah nindanam karoti.
Criticizes.
Nindanam. Oh,
okay. Nindati scolds. Scolding. Balakah nindanti scolds. Nindanam karoti. Okay.
Simhah garjati. Simhah garjanam karoti.
You know this. Okay.
Yeah. Vriddhah chintayati. Vriddhah chintanam karoti. Thinking.
Chintayati. Things. Yeah, thinking. Chintayati, not causative and all. Okay. Because you don't connect with patayati. Chintayati is things only.
Okay. Saha shrunoti. Saha shravanam karoti.
Listens. Shrunoti.
Okay.
He listens. He does listening. Saha shravanam karoti. Okay.
Saha snati. Saha snanam karoti.
Yes.
Balakaha nidrati. Balakaha nidram karoti. Balika rachayati. Balika rachanam karoti.
So rachayati writes. Writes. Rachanam karoti. Writes are rachayati composes. Rachanam karoti. See, he.
Just composition.
Composition. I think we can stop here. Please note the page number. Next one is Abhyasa 41. Page number
97.
114. 114. So we stop here. Any doubts? You can ask. And please go through this exercise. You spend more time on this. 1 week, please, sir. 1 week. In fact, generally, I take 2 weeks, two classes a week, Sanskritam. But it's too much for you. And some people said, that's why I made it to one class. One class is one weekly, one class only. So you've got time. Daily spend at least 15 minutes. Not more than 15 minutes. So at the end of 1 year, you are 2 years, you will see a lot of things you have completed. That's why I started another Sanskritam class long back. Now it is more than 250 classes. In fact, 300 classes. That is advanced class. Another class, which is intermediate, it is about 160 classes. Two classes a week, actually, that one. So, go into great details now. Advanced class is that is one, intermediate. And another very advanced is Ashtadhyayi. That is another level, sutras, so different level. This is a basic level. So from basic, you have to slowly come up. So you need to do homework. Only I can raise the standard of the class.
Sure, Guruji.
So,
yes, Guruji. We'll do that.
Yes, weekly one class, so it will be slow only. So, relaxed today, but not completely relaxed also. And send the link for the Gita class to this group, WhatsApp group. If you're interested, please join. And if you join,
yes,
plan to join, join regularly. Okay. So, understanding the Gita is very important. People have wrong idea about Gita. Wrong notions are there about Gita. It's not a bedtime storybook. Somebody said it's just some they read whenever they have some issues and problem. They refer to Gita. They find solution. That is not the one. That is not the purpose of Gita alone. A lot of things are there, Gita. We need not know all the other texts. At least Gita, we know. Being a Hindu, it's very important.
Yes.
Every other religious person, they read their own books. But we have got so many books. We don't have to read all the books. At least Gita, we must know. If somebody asks, what is Gita? What does it teach? You should be able to say. What is your religion? It says. Should be able to speak and make them understand. First, we have to understand.
Yep.
Important, Gita. It has a, if you have a value for it, then definitely you will go for it. Right?
Yep.
Okay. Stop here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti
Hari Hari Om Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha Hari Om.
Dhanyavad Guru.